What's up guys, Saf here on Super Saf TV, and it's finally here, the Xiaomi Mi 11 Ultra. This thing is an absolute beast and it has been the most requested device to cover on the channel recently. So a thumbs up for your boy for bringing it would be appreciated. Let's go ahead, get it unboxed and see what it has to offer. So inside the box, as well as the device, you do get a USB Type A to USB Type C cable, a 67 watt charger included out of the box. As well as that, there's a SIM card tool, some paperwork, a clear case, and a USB Type C to 3.5 millimeter headphone adapter. And let's get to the device. All right, holy camera module. This thing is thick. I don't think I've seen a bigger camera module in my life. This thing like literally takes up the whole top of the device and it is quite a bit of a camera bump as well. Well, I guess one advantage of the camera module is that it's not gonna rock when it's on the table because it just literally takes up the full back section. That is insane. So we'll talk about the cameras in a little bit. Let's initially take a look at the display. So we've got an in-display fingerprint scanner. This is a 6.81 inch Super AMOLED display with a Quad HD Plus resolution, 120 hertz refresh rate, 480 hertz touch sampling rate, and it has a peak brightness of 1700 nits, which makes this, I believe, the brightest smartphone display on the market right now. I think the S21 Ultra is around 1500 nits, so this just takes it a step above, which is perfect for me because, you know, these. Now we've got Gorilla Glass Victus, and it is a curved display. It kind of curves in from all of the edges. Pretty small bezels with a punch out for the selfie camera. Now the selfie camera is 20 megapixels, but you may not be using it as much because we actually have a rear display as well to help you take your selfies. So within this humongous camera module at the back, you do have a 1.1 inch AMOLED display. And this is an always on display, so it can show you things like the time and notifications. But if you do want to take selfies using the rear facing cameras, which are obviously much better in quality, then this can also be used as a viewfinder. So I've just switched on the rear display and it's actually pretty cool because I can just take selfies using the volume down key. So, and you can, it's actually pretty clear, this small display. What's also really cool about this display is that you can use multiple cameras. So if you do want to use the ultra wide and get lots of people in for a group shot, then you'll be able to do that and still be able to see yourself. So I really do like this rear display. Right now, let's talk about the cameras. So we have a 50 megapixel primary camera, and this is using the new Samsung GN2 sensor, which is 1/1.2 inches. That makes it the largest smartphone sensor on the market right now. Quite impressive here. We then have a 48 megapixel ultra wide camera with a 128 degree angle of view. This is using the Sony IMX586 sensor. And then the periscope zoom camera is also using the Sony IMX586 sensor. This will give you 5x optical zoom, 10x hybrid zoom, and Xiaomi is saying up to 120x digital zoom. So it looks like they're trying to get a one up on Samsung with the 100x zoom, but I'm not sure how well it will do considering the optical zoom range is just 5x. So that's gonna be quite a bit of digital zoom, whereas something like the S21 Ultra does have 10x optical zoom. So I would assume that will give you better results at around 100x, although I don't use 100x much. Definitely let me know in the comments below if you'd like me to do a Super Saf style camera comparison of this versus the Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra or another device. And also be sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you don't miss any future coverage. Right now, let's take a look around the device. We do have a metal frame Gorilla Glass Victus at the front, as mentioned, but we've got a ceramic back. So this is the ceramic white. There is also a ceramic black version available. So it definitely looks and feels very premium, but it is quite a heavy device. And I mean, the weight distribution isn't bad, but I can't help but notice that very big camera module at the top. On the right-hand side, we've got a power button as well as a volume rocker. Nothing on the left-hand side. At the top, it looks like we've got an IR blaster as well as one of the two speakers. So we've got one at the top and one at the bottom. Now these speakers have sound by Harman Kardon and have a powerful custom super linear speaker unit. And Xiaomi have said that this has the loudest speakers in the market. Let's go ahead and test that out. So I've got some royalty free music so I don't get sued. Let's test this out at a max volume. Okay. That's definitely loud. Also at the bottom, we've got a USB type C port as well as the SIM card tray. Now internally, this is powered by the Qualcomm Snapdragon 888 5G chipset. We've got 12 gigabytes of LPDDR5 RAM and 256 gigabytes of UFS 3.1 storage. So it's right up there in terms of the specs. For software, we do have Android 11 with MIUI on top. And for the battery, we've got a pretty big 5,000 milliamp hour battery. Now remember, we've got 67 watt wired charging, which is included out of the box. But on top of that, we also have 67 watt wireless charging. Now that is the fastest wireless charging in the market right now. And Xiaomi have said that there's virtually no difference in terms of speed between the wired and wireless charging. And you can get a full charge on that 5,000 milliamp hour battery in around 36 minutes. Now, of course, you will have to buy a 67 watt wireless charger separately, which can output that level of power. And you also have 10 watt reverse wireless charging, which again is pretty fast compared to lots of the other competition if you do want to charge something on the back of the Mi 11 Ultra. Now for pricing, I only have the European pricing, which is around 1200 euros, puts it quite in line with other flagships like the S21 Ultra, and that is the Xiaomi Mi 11 Ultra. It's definitely a beast of a phone. I'm still not quite sure how I feel about this massive camera bump and camera module, although I really do like this rear display, and I can't wait to test these cameras out a little bit more. What do you guys think of the Xiaomi Mi 11 Ultra? Definitely let me know in the comments below. Also let me know what further coverage you'd like to do with this. And if you want to see all of that further coverage, then do subscribe and hit that bell icon. I've just checked the statistics and only around 40% of you guys watching are subscribed, so the other 60%, go ahead, subscribe. And if you enjoyed this video and found it useful, then do smash that like button for me. Thanks for watching. This is Saf on SuperSaf TV. I'll see you next time.